Hello, and thank you for joining. My name is Jesse Snow, and this is Daily Bread. Today, we're going to start reading out of Exodus chapter 36, verse 1. Now, new visitors are always welcome, so make sure to share this to social media. But before we get started, let's open in a word of prayer. Our Father who is in heaven, holy is your name. Your kingdom come, and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us of our trespasses as we forgive those who trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Here's Exodus chapter 36, verse 1. And Bezalel and Aholab and every gifted artisan in whom the Lord has put wisdom and understanding to know how to do all manner of work for the service of the sanctuary, shall do according to all the Lord has commanded. Then Moses called Bezalel and Aholab and every gifted artisan in whose heart the Lord had put wisdom, everyone whose heart was stirred to come and do the work. And they received from Moses and all the offering which the children of Israel had brought for the work of the service of making the sanctuary. So they continued bringing to him free will offerings every morning. Then all the craftsmen who were doing all the work of the sanctuary came, each from the work he was doing. And they spoke to Moses, saying, "The people bring much more than enough for the service of the work which the Lord commanded us to do." So Moses gave a commandment, and they caused it to be proclaimed throughout the camp, saying, "Let neither man nor woman do any more work for the offering of the sanctuary." And the people were restrained from bringing. For the material they had was sufficient for all the work to be done, indeed, too much. Then all the gifted artisans among them who worked on the tabernacle made 10 curtains of woven fine linen and a blue, purple, and scarlet thread. With artistic designs of cherubim, they made them. The length of each curtain was 28 cubits, and the width of each curtain 4 cubits. The curtains were all the same size. And he coupled 5 curtains to one another, and the other 5 curtains he coupled to one another. He made loops of blue yarn on the edge of the curtain on the selvage of one set. Likewise he did on the other edge of the other curtain of the second set. 50 loops he made on one curtain, and 50 loops he made on the edge of the curtain on the edge of the second set. The loops held one curtain to another. And he made 50 clasps of gold, coupled the curtains to one another with the clasps, that it might be one tabernacle. He made curtains of goat's hair for the tent over the tabernacle. He made 11 curtains. The 11th of each curtain was 30 cubits, and the width of each curtain 4 cubits. The 11 curtains were the same size. And he made 50 loops on the edge of the curtain, that is othermost in one set, and 50 loops he made on the edge of the curtain of the second set. He also made 50 bronze clasps to couple the tent together, that it might be one. Then he made a covering for a covering of badger skin above that. For the tabernacle, he made boards of acacia wood, standing upright. The length of each board was 10 cubits, and the width of each board a cubit and a half. Each board had 2 tenons for binding one to another. Thus he made for all the boards of the tabernacle. And he made boards for the tabernacle, 20 boards for the south side. 40 sockets of silver he made to go under the 20 boards, 2 sockets under each of the boards for its 2 tenons. And for the other side of the tabernacle, the north side, he made 20 boards. And there 40 sockets of silver, 2 sockets under each of the boards. For the west side of the tabernacle, he made 6 boards. He also made 2 boards for the 2 back corners of the tabernacle, and they were coupled at the bottom and coupled together at the top by 1 ring. Thus he made both of them for the 2 corners. So there were 8 boards and their sockets, 16 sockets of silver, 2 sockets under each of the boards. And he made bars of acacia wood, 5 for the boards on one side of the tabernacle, 5 bars for the boards on the other side of the tabernacle, and 5 boards for the boards, and 5 bars for the boards of the tabernacle on the far side westward. And he made the middle bar to pass through the boards from one end to the other. He overlaid the boards with gold, made their rings of gold to be holders for the bars, and overlaid the bars with gold. And he made the veil of blue, purple, and scarlet thread and fine woven linen. It was worked with an artistic design of cherubim. He made for it 4 pillars of the acacia wood and overlaid them with gold, with their hooks of gold, and he cast 4 sockets of silver for them. He also made a screen for the tabernacle door of blue, purple, and scarlet thread and fine woven linen made by a weaver, and its 5 pillars with their hooks, and overlaid their capitals and their rings with gold, but their 5 sockets were bronze. We're going to stop right there at Exodus chapter 37 today. I'd like to thank everybody again for joining. I really do hope you enjoyed reading along with me. If you did, you can hit that thumbs up button. If you'd like to continue to read along with me, you can subscribe and hit the bell for notifications when I upload the videos. Now, we're going to get started at chapter 37 next time. But before we go, let's close in a word of prayer. Lord God, thank you for all that you do. Thank you for allowing us to come and gather around your word. Thank you just for allowing this to happen. We just pray that your word is heard throughout the world, that every ear will have heard your gospel and know who you are. Father, thank you for all that you provide for us. You are a well in the desert. You are a meal during a celebration. Father, you filled the table with an abundance. Thank you for allowing us to come. You are our King and our God. We will always worship you. Amen.